From Seattle, Washington, and about a year ago, January, February, I started feeling a little bit of pain in my upper right hand breast, and I went in for my mammogram, and they were checking, and I told them about the pain, and they found a spot, and they wanted to go ahead and do a sonogram right there and then, and they did that, and they said, no, you need to come back in for a biopsy. And they set it up for the very next day, and it turned out to be cancer. When they did the biopsy, it was invasive, but it was very small, and apparently it had just broken out. So I had a little bit of DCIS and invasive. And I kind of went into a fog, honestly. They were like, okay, we're going to line you up with the surgeon, we're going to do a lumpectomy and radiation, and you'll be fine. And I really kind of went into a total daze and shock. I wound up calling my insurance company to kind of tell them what was going on and, you know, figure out what I needed to do. And fortunately for me, the insurance woman that I was talking with, she said, honey, you know you can get a second opinion. And it was like, that was what I needed to wake me up. I think I've had a lot of friends that have been through this and family members. And when you first get diagnosed, that really is what happened. You go into a shock, you go into this almost like denial, and it's so easy to get swept along with whatever the doctor at the time is telling you to do because they're the expert. And I was so fortunate because when she told me I could get a second opinion, it was like, oh my goodness, this is my life, it's my body, and I do research for everybody else and for everything else day in, day out for my work, and I haven't done one thing for myself. So I got busy and I started doing tons of research on the internet. I started talking to other women who had had cancer, and I was going to the doctors back in Seattle, and they were pushing for me to have a lumpectomy and radiation. And the more I found out about it, the more I don't really think that's the right path for me, but I was willing to consider it. But I wanted to get an MRI because to see if there was anything in the other breast. I'd known too many other people that had been through having it in one breast and then finding out later they had it in the other. And I did have an MRI, and they found an area of atypical hyperplasia in my left breast. About that time, as I started finding out about my options on the internet and talking with the doctors there, I started realizing that the path I wanted to take was to have a bilateral mastectomy and have a reconstruction. I found PRMA online, and part of it was through when I went in to find out about the procedure, and that is bilateral mastectomy with immediate reconstruction with a DIEP flap. And fortunately, I found their site, and they had wonderful pictures and explanations, and I could just, it really set me on the track to start to see better what I would look like or what the possible outcomes were. And I got very excited about that. I talked about trying to get that procedure back home, but they were not going to be able to schedule me for about 3 months or 4 months out. When I called down to PRMA, the patient liaison, Gina, she was wonderful, and she was like, helped me right away to get everything uploaded, my pictures and my records. And within 2 weeks, they were calling me back. I mean, they talked to me in between, so I mean, it's just like a family. I mean, they take care of you. But they had me set up for surgery the following week, and it was wonderful. We drove down actually from Seattle. And met with the doctors on Monday. Now, one of the things that was thrilling to me was because I had been told that they wouldn't, if I had a bilateral mastectomy and the reconstruction with the deep flap, I would not be able to have my nipples, and they said I wouldn't have any feeling, and they wouldn't do the nerve repair reconnection. Well, the first thing when I met Dr. Pisano, and he starts looking at me, he says, of course we want to save your nipple on the side that doesn't have cancer, and let's take a look at where the cancer is, and maybe we can save it on the right-hand side. And I just about went into tears because it was so unexpected and such a blessing. And then I asked him about, can you do something with the nerves? And yes, of course, we do the nerve repair too. So I wound up having my procedure. They were able to save both of my nipples. I'm blessed. I have full feeling, and I got mine right away. I just had my revision surgery a week ago today, and I still have all my sensation, and I love the results. I feel good, and I'm just very grateful about the whole process. I think the main thing that I really want to try to convey to women is that, yes, as soon as you get that diagnosis, you are going to go into that shock and that daze, but just stop and try to remember that you have to speak up for yourself and you have to look for what is best for you. I'm thrilled with my results because I opted to go the way that I did. I was fortunate. It was very small, and I didn't have any lymph node involvement, so I did not have to have radiation, and I did not have to have chemotherapy. And I understand that each case is individual, but for me, it was the right choice, and definitely the way to go. The people here are fantastic. I've been recommending them to everybody, and I can't say enough. It's been a wonderful experience all the way around, and Dr. Pisano is a genius. He's absolutely fabulous, and best decision that I ever made.